Rice Stadium in Houston, Texas, the site of our college football showdown. This coin toss presented by Nissan, innovation that excites. Fox is on the field to kick this one off, and everyone in the stadium is ready for this game to get started. He's to the 20. He got hit hard. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. He's going to try and scramble. They bring him down.
Outstanding job there by the linebacker to find his way through on the blitz.
From their own 22-yard line, second down. Throws complete. He's got room to work. And he's tackled in the open field.
Keep those chains moving. Just a simple out route that time, and it was enough to beat the zone defense.
From their own 39-yard line, it's first down. He makes it out to about the 41-yard line. Love gains about 2 yards on the run.
I'm telling you, every yard you gain is earned, and those were about as tough as they come.
Hands it off on the delay, and he's shoved out of bounds at the 46-yard line. From their own 46-yard line, third down. After a decent run up the gut. So he picked up a few on that run.
Yeah, he did a nice job of using his blockers on that run. Really a nice read.
There's a strike complete. And they make the stop at the 37.
Looks like the defense played the run that time. With this offense, you've got to be ready for a pass on any down in any situation.
First and 10. Ball on the 37. Tackled after a decent pickup. Here's the eighth play of the series. Away. Nice job getting a hand on that one.
Yeah, really good heads-up play there to get a hand on the football by the defense.
And so it's another third down upcoming here. Catches it, and he's looking for more.
That was a good reaction to the blitzing linebacker. That's what you like to see out of a young quarterback. He just has to ignore the pressure and get the ball out of there on time.
10th play of the drive. Made at the 21. Second and 13. Ball on the 21-yard line. Caught, open field. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
They look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice gain.
Hey. Well, they'll line it up again on third down. Two for two so far on this drive. And he's tackled after positive yardage.
Brad, you just don't see this very often anymore in college football. That is their fifth first down on this drive alone. They have great rhythm right now as an offense. And look at that poor defense. They're looking over to the sidelines for the defensive coordinator for some help. They need to change things up.
And he's tackled just outside the goal line. From the 1 yard line, it's second down. They're trying to stop the run here with a goal line defense. Another give, and he's going to be wrestled down for a loss. And this is the 15th play of the current drive. Room around the corner. Touchdown, Stanford! And he converts the extra point. A long 15-play, 75-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points. Stanford to kick. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. And he's level at the 33. They bring him down in the backfield.
Too easy, too easy.
They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down.
Here we go.
Gets it off as he's hit, complete. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield. Irwin back deep to return. Oh, excellent punt. Irwin fields it at the 27, and he has it on the corner. Brought down at the 43. 6 points and a pretty display of passing was a result of their last drive. Kirk, do you expect the defense to take a different approach here?
When this quarterback is on, he is on. It already seems like whatever this defense is trying just isn't working. But maybe if they add just a little bit more pressure, then they might be able to force him into a mistake.
From their own 40-yard line, second down. Stanford is up by a touchdown. He heaves it deep. The freshman makes the catch. Touchdown! Nicely designed play to the wide receiver, and it got him six.
You said it, Brad, and a good time to call it. I tip my hat to the offensive coordinator.
It was a pretty simple route, but they run it to perfection for the score. And he hits the PAT. A short two-play, 57-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points. So the score now, 14-0. Bailey, ready to kick. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's tackled at the 20. The offense takes the field again. They were forced to punt their last time out.
They've been beaten soundly on both sides of the ball, and we haven't even gotten to the second quarter.
kill it.
He's scrambling. He gets sacked on the play. For the sack. So the sack makes this third and very long.
Here we go.
He throws right. They can't connect. Incomplete.
Let's see if the momentum from that defensive stand carries over to their offense.
They're stacking the line. It looks like they're coming after this punt. Stanford's not taking anything for granted. They were supposed to do this, and so far they are doing what they expected to do.
Yeah, they've done a really nice job of just taking care of business. The offense is clicking, quarterback's making good decisions. The defense has been very impressive as well.
The offense was able to punch it in the end zone on that last drive. They'll come back out looking for more of the same.
Well, I think this defense has got to do something, because right now the quarterback is in such a good rhythm that you've got to do something to try to get him out of it. I would suggest trying to bring more pressure. Try to come up with an exotic blitz look to try to get him on his heels as opposed to being the aggressor and attacking the defense.
From the 31-yard line, first down. As we change ends of the field, I don't think we're going to be seeing much of a change in the outcome. 14-0, Stanford. Back to the action now here in the second quarter. Run there. Love gains about 4 yards on the play. Second and 6 coming up here. Ball on the 27-yard line. They line up in the jumbo set. Handoff to the right. They'll drop him for a loss. Flips it middle to the running back. He's tackled at the 31-yard line.
Why in the world would the offense run a route short for the first down? That just baffles me every time I see that.
It looks like they're going to try for the long field goal. The kick is up. It's got the distance. And he just drilled it from long range. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Things are on the verge of getting out of hand before we even hit the half. These next few drives are going to go a long way in determining what kind of game this will end up being. Here's a handoff up the middle and no room to run. And the halfback's got nowhere to go.
There was simply no daylight on that play. The defender came in and dropped the hammer.
Makes the catch, and he's got nowhere to go.
Let's go, hurry up, hold the ball, hold the ball.
To his tailback again. He's knocked out of bounds at the 28. That series left the offense scratching their heads a little. Fox awaits the snap.
Right.
gets out to about the 42-yard line. It's still only the second quarter. We've got a lot of football left, but I've got to say, this one is teetering on the brink of a blowout. He's at midfield. And he is drilled at the 41.
Good solid running right there. Getting past a defensive lineman and into the secondary before he could be stopped.
From the 41-yard line, first down.
Three down.
49's the mic. Watch 49. Here we go.
Up the middle for a nice gain. They come out in a goal line set. Hands off up the middle and stuffed. Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 31. He scrambled, and he's going to be sacked for a loss. They'll line it up for a very long field goal attempt. Kicks away. And it hits the crossbar, no good. Things are on the verge of getting out of hand before we even hit the half. These next few drives are going to go a long way in determining what kind of game this will end up being. Brought down at the 49-yard line. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers. And he's hit immediately. And they've got all their DBs in there to match up against the five-wide set. Quick throw. He's at the 30. There's a very impressive open field tackle.
This guy has that innate ability to get just enough distance from a defender to make a completion possible. You don't see it from every receiver, but this guy's got it.
Steps out of bounds around the 22-yard line. They come out in a five-wide set. Quick shot to the open receiver, and he can't hang on to the ball. Third down, and they need to get it to the 15. He's going to try and scramble. Diving for extra yardage. Quick throw out to the receiver. Incomplete.
I'm not going to fault that decision. It was definitely a first down that they could have picked up. You want to be aggressive early on, even if it doesn't always work out.
It's still only the second quarter. We've got a lot of football left, but I've got to say, this one is teetering on the brink of a blowout. Scrambling around. And they bring him down for a sack on the play.
A defensive end with this kind of speed is an offense's worst nightmare. He's got the ability to collapse the pocket on any given pass play. And as a play caller, you constantly have to be aware of it. Whether you're going to roll away from him or you're going to chip with a tight end or a running back, you're constantly concerned and aware of a big, strong defensive end.
They'll line up at the 11. Third down. And down he goes, right around the 14-yard line. So they run the ball on third and long, and it's stuck.
Well, Brad, here the offense is trying to surprise the defense with a run, but it didn't work.
Banks is back awaiting the punt. He punts it away, and it's a great kick. Banks fields it at the 40. He's taken down at the 48.
Things are on the verge of getting out of hand before we even hit the half. These next few drives are going to go a long way in determining what kind of game this will end up being.
He guns it. Caught! The 10. Touchdown, Rice! Wide receiver flew down the field on that touchdown connection.
Well, he has the speed to stretch the defense, and his hands are getting better every single game.
Brad, the quarterback and this wide receiver clearly have outstanding chemistry. Wide receiver is so open because it was a perfect route, and the quarterback was able to time it up just perfectly.
He makes the PAT. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Excellent kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Stanford's put themselves in a great position now as they head into the second half.
Well, in the first half, we saw a lot of big playability and just an explosive approach by this offense. But remember, we'll see what happens here in the second half. This is a long way from being over.
They were forced to punt the ball away the last time they had it. They'll be looking for a little more out of their offense on this possession.
And he can't get away from the pressure. They find themselves in a hole here after that sack. It's second and long. Gross falling back and got his man. And he's tackled right around the 36-yard line. First and 10. Ball on their own 36. Got it. And he goes down quickly. That reception good for around 4 yards.
He took what the defense gave him that time, which is okay. It keeps the yards to go a little bit more manageable.
Throws complete. He's got room to work. Knocked out of bounds at the 45-yard line. And he's taken down right around the 46-yard line. Now he's scrambling. He's taken down at the 48-yard line. To throw outside. Intercepted by the linebacker. He's at the 30, tackled at the 22.
What kind of call is that? With a big lead, you're throwing the football, and the interception here could end up costing.
The 22-yard line. It's first down. The Owls are going to call their second timeout. He ran a good-looking route and picked up positive yardage.
That he did, and he made a good catch. That short passing game is where you see all those hours in the summer that you put in pay off.
Now he tries. tries to buy some time, and he's sacked.
This quarterback has to do a better job of avoiding the rush, because sacks can be real drive killers.
So with the half ending, they're just going to try to put 3 points up on the board. It's up, and he's got it.
They're probably just going to squib this kick. I don't think they want to see the return man create lightning before halftime.
Love fields it at the one. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line.
We played a half of football. The Cardinal lead, 17-10.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. Both quarterbacks have had a lot of company, guys in opposite colored jerseys in their backfield, in their grills in the first half. And you're starting to see a little frustration from these quarterbacks.
Yeah, that was always one of the favorite parts about getting after a quarterback, is they do get frustrated and they start looking at their offensive line with a puzzled look. And sometimes they even tell them that their breath stinks or something really unnice that you can't say on TV or in this game. So, you know, it's fun to get them rattled, to get them frustrated, because you know it's going to pay dividends down the road. And especially when they turn to that offensive line, they're like, really, dude? You really can't protect me any better than that.
Just about time to start the second half. What do you think Herb Street's first point of analysis will be?
I don't know. Something to do with quarterback play, I'm sure. We always got to hear that stuff all the time. It's all about the quarterbacks.
Brad and Kirk ready for the second half.
And we welcome you back to the action here. Just about set for the second half. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking, if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. They'll bring him down at the 28-yard line. He's hit right away. Tackle made at the 31. Irwin is the deep man awaiting the return. It's away and it's a booming punt. Irwin takes it to 21. He makes it to the 35-yard line. And for Padgett, he certainly made an impact.
Well, Brad, to me, it really just looks like it's just men against boys out there. This guy's been in on so many plays, it's like its own highlight film. To me, this is just a classic example of just being bigger, faster and stronger than the guy trying to block you. I don't care if this offensive line uses two or even three guys to stop him. There's nothing they can do to stop this individual performance that he's putting on display today.
The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Stanford is up a score. He makes it out to maybe the 43-yard line. They go to the ground and he stops short. Wait. waiting for the snap. Gets out to about the 31. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. He's on the run. Boy, this defense really came to play today.
Well, they said before the game that they wanted to put a lot of pressure on this quarterback. They sure stuck to that plan.
So the sack makes this a second and long. Fires out quickly to the tailback. And they make the stop around the 20-yard line. It all going long and got him. Very clutch tackle there because this kid had some space. Play action here. He's going to scramble. They'll make the sack. They get to the quarterback and end that play before it even got started.
This young man didn't even have a chance to make something happen. It's tough to find your receivers when the defense is in your face like that.
Second down, 15 to go. Ball on the 33-yard line. Here's the give. This one might be coming back, folks. Let's check out the penalty. That one will put the offense in a hole, and they'll try to get some of that back on this upcoming play. Second down and a ways to go because of the penalty. Run and he's brought down. He might not be able to get the pass off. Quick throw incomplete. One on his receiver. They call on the kicker for a long field goal. Kicks up, and it sails right on him. No good.
You know, for a second there, I thought it might hook back, but it just kept slicing to the right. That's a tough break.
The defense really shut these guys down the last time they had the ball. Stanford up 7 points. Tackle after a decent run up the gut. It's second down, six to go. Ball on the 43. And he's stopped behind the line. Up a screen. Tailback's got it. He's knocked out of bounds at the 49. Banks is back to receive. And this one is a beauty. This one will go into the end zone and they'll bring it out to the 20. For Stanford,
they're really getting after the quarterback tonight. Great job by the defense tonight, getting into the backfield and creating issues for this line. This defense is still feeling the pressure of the passing game.
Yeah, the secondary and linebackers aren't able to make a play at the point of catch a lot of times.
And for Rice, they have only one play that went for more than 20 yards. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. And they get nice yardage on that run. He has some room. Big opening. He makes his way to about the 38. Run to the outside. Big opening. Brought down at the 47-yard line. Right side for a good game. Second down and 5. Ball on the 42.
Let's go!
On the ground, left side. He's tackled at the 41. Drill at the 40. So at the end of 3, the Cardinal lead 17-10. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter. He's on the run. Gains his way to the 30-yard line.
That's another first down, Brad. And right now, you can just really feel and sense the rhythm that this offense is in. Their ability to pick up first downs is pushing this defense further and further down, back deep into their own territory.
He gets out to about the 21-yard line. Gets out to about the 18-yard line. He's going to try and scramble, and they get the sack. This is the 13th play of this drive. Backup quarterback into the game now to call the signals.
Green 95.
Check, check. Stingray.
They go to the back, and he's hit immediately in the backfield. Third and very long, and it's going to take a miracle to convert here. Here comes the pressure, and they bring him down for a sack on the play.
Fourth and long here after the sack. The kick is up, and he splits the uprights. Rice, ready to kick this one off. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20. He's taken down at the 26-yard line.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game.
Stanford is up four. And he hits him hard at the 35. It's second down now. They're just a few feet away from that first down marker. And he's tackled at the 37. He'll get the call again. And down he goes,
around the 48-yard line.
Check. First and 10. Ball on the 48. Makes it out to about the 43. Taken down at the 40-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 40. At the 12. So on first down, they go to the air and pick up huge yardage.
Well, that was just a well-executed play. They picked a perfect time to stretch the defense with a passing play, and it worked.
First down, 10 yards to go.
Ball on the 12-yard line.
Just under three to go in regulation.
Receiver on this play. He beat his man off the line and then ran a perfect route. All he had to do after that was make the catch.
What great catch by the wide receiver, and the guy who needs to be thanking him is the quarterback. That's not where he wanted that ball to go, but the receiver made the catch and saved the quarterback for a touchdown.
He makes the PAT. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He really got a hold of that kick.
This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. 3 points was the result of their last drive as the offense heads out for another. Scrambling around. bounces off a would-be tackler. He's taken down right around the 26-yard line. To the receiver, incomplete. From their own 26-yard line, third down, just under two to go in the game. Throws, and a man wide open, and he missed it. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, five wide receivers in the formation. Got him. They try to throw for it, but ended up getting sacked.
When the first down marker is that far away, someone's got to step up and make a play on fourth down. It just didn't happen for him here.
Not much of a problem getting the ball in the end zone on their last drive as this quarterback just picked apart the defense.
Well, it's one thing to have speed. It's another thing to have an idea of what you're doing and how to attack the defense. And right now, these wide receivers clearly have done an outstanding job in being able to make their reads and getting out of their breaks, and the quarterback picked the ball right on the money.
Love gets the call. Good outside run there. And the defense gives up some free yards to the offense.
Penalties can ruin a team's chances to win if they commit too many.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Love picks up five with the carry. The Owls call a timeout. That's their second of the half. They're trying to stop the run here with a goal line defense. He's got the corner. Touchdown, Cardinal. Well, that touchdown should just about ice this one. And he hits the PAT with a three-play, 15-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard. The score now, 31-13. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. And the defense made a big stop on fourth down the last time this offense was out there.
And this offense comes out on the field again after being stopped on downs the last time out. And not only does that affect them in a negative way, but you know what it does is it gives this defense that they're facing a ton of confidence and a lot of momentum as they come back out on the field.
Second and 10. Ball on their own 25. A little over a minute in the game.
Ready! Light 80!
He airs it out. Almost picked off. Receiver. They'll bring him down around the 28-yard line. It's fourth down, and they're going to try to go for it. And that just might do it. Intercepted. He came up with a fantastic interception there.
Well, you know the quarterback is kicking himself for that one. He just made the wrong read.
And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. And the quarterback's going to take a knee to drain this clock and any hopes the opposition may have had. Second and 12 coming up here. Ball on the 34. And they make the stop
around the 17-yard line.
Very well-designed play that time to give him a first down. The linemen executed their blocks nicely, and it went for a good gain.
And the ball game's over, and our final score in this one, 31-13, Stanford. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.